Robbie and Nen in your analysis, you also looked at some very interesting political parties.
Well, as always, you have to have a look at the really interesting political parties. They're probably not going to make it or make much progress, but there are a couple of very interesting political parties that I've decided to look at for specific reasons.
So one of them is the Land Party. Why did you choose them?
Yeah, the Land Party is an interesting one. The origins of the Land Party is from the protest that we saw in Hermanus last year. So the first impression is that it is a very radical left-leaning political party, and the name, the Land Party. But that is in fact not the case. They are actually quite free market orientated. Look at their policies. Their suggestions is that South Africa, economically speaking, must move to the right. I think they're quite uncertain what they really stand for. Ideologically, there's a lot of confusion, and they don't really have, they have a lot of policies, but I'm not sure that they actually believe in their own policies. But the important thing for me, for the Land Party, is that there's a young, vibrant bunch, previously disadvantaged, that's actually a political party on the right of the political spectrum. Keep an eye on them for the future.
Interesting. And then the Good Party. I hope they're good.
The Good Party, that's Patricia de Lille. And I'm afraid there's probably nothing good about the Good Party. And as long as Patricia de Lille is there, you simply cannot believe anything that the Good Party stands for. And that is because Patricia de Lille has been everywhere. She started her political career in a PAC with all sort of radical ideas. And from there on, she moved to everything that you can think of. She has been with everybody, and she supported everything, and she supported nothing. So that what is clear about Patricia de Lille, she simply does not have values that one can trust over time. And I do not believe anything that the Good Party says. Good is certainly not good.
I take it you're not a fan then. What about the ZAPC?
Yeah, the Capitalist Party of South Africa, that's an interesting bunch. What I like about the Capitalist Party of South Africa is that the emblem is a purple cow. They're young, they're hip, they don't take themselves too seriously. In terms of their ideology, they're certainly right-leaning, believe in a free market kind of system, but they still have to figure out what they really stand for. They don't really have policies, but I really do like young people entering the political arena, and I think that's a party. Keep an eye on them, but they need some leadership and perhaps a little bit more experience.
And then the last one in this category is the Cape Party. That's quite interesting, I
think. Yeah, the Cape Party is interesting for me because I believe that the rot in South Africa, economically speaking, has reached such a state that there's a possibility over time that the center of South Africa, especially the fiscal part and the central political structures in South Africa, can come under even more and more strain. And that is the structures that keep South Africa's political unity intact. And for that reason, I believe over time, regional parties like the Cape Party that want to secede from the rest of South Africa will become more important over time. And there is even a possibility over time that South Africa can fall apart politically. And if that should happen one day, a party like the Cape Party will become far more important.
Interesting.